हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज द वीडियो नंबर 13 ऑफ फिजिक्स ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 4. इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वीडियो नंबर 12 वी हैव स्टडीड द फोर्स मैग्नेटिक फोर्स एक्टिंग बिटवीन टू पैरेलल करंट कैरिंग वायर्स एंड दैट फोर्स वाज गिवन बाय एफ इज इक्वल्स टू म्यू जीरो आई ए आई बी एल अपॉन 2πd. ओके, we have also calculated one example of exercise and I have given you in homework one illustration example. Here in video number 13 we will see torque on a rectangular current loop in a uniform magnetic field. Now you know that if a current carrying loop is placed in uniform magnetic field, then on it there will be act some magnetic force, and then magnetic force is given by F is equals to IL cross B. Okay, this is the old topic of this chapter. Okay, it is in previous videos, you can refer that. I think that will be in video number 8 or 9. F is equals to IL cross B. Okay, now from this formula we can say that if current and magnetic field will be in same direction, then there will be no magnetic force. Okay, but if current and magnetic field will perpendicular to each other, then there will be magnetic force of ILB. We will use this in this theory of torque. Now see, suppose we are having one rectangular loop. I am drawing one rectangular loop. Suppose this is one rectangular loop. It is placed in uniform magnetic field. To show that uniform magnetic field, here we are showing two magnets. One magnet of north pole, another magnet has north pole towards the rectangular loop. Now here I am showing the brushes and one ring, but you don't worry about it because we will study it in detail in AC current. Okay, in generation of AC current, why the ring and brushes are placed, but you don't right now worry about it. So there is one ring and brush placed, one circuit is completed. Okay, now this is the battery, and suppose when battery is on, then current will be flow from the positive side. So current will be flow from this side, current I, and it will completely loop here. Okay, north pole, south pole. So here in this loop there will be magnetic field in this direction from north to south. Okay, this will be axis of the rectangular loop. Why we are mentioning the axis? The axis is most important. Okay, if axis is not drawn in this figure, then your marks will be cut. Why axis is important? Because here, due to torque, this rectangular loop will be rotate. Okay, and it will rotate about this axis. Okay, so this is the rotational axis. Of the rectangular loop. A rectangular loop has one dimension of B. This dimension is small b and this one dimension is small a. Okay, so rectangular has this one dimension small a and here another dimension small b. Magnetic field is capital B in this direction. Current is flowing from this rectangular loop, closed loop. Okay, now we are giving the name like A, B, C and D. Here we can say that there are actually four wires, wires A, B, B, C, C, D and D A here, and from this wire current is flowing in this magnetic field, so there will be magnetic force generated on this wire. Now see, on wire A, D and wire B, C, first of all on wire A, D and B, C, what is happening? On wire AD, first of all, magnetic field B and current I are, see, anti-parallel, means they are actually in, they are, we can also say parallel, because because see, here current is in this direction, but magnetic field is in this direction, so theta will be 180. So if theta is 0 or theta is 180, then magnetic force is 0. So angle between B and I, magnetic field and current, the theta is 180. If theta is 180, then magnetic force will be 0. So on this AD, on this AD wire, there will be no magnetic force, same as BC. On BC, see, current I and magnetic field is in same direction. So theta is equals to 0, so again magnetic force will be 0. But see, on AB, what is happening? Current I is in upward direction and magnetic field is in this direction. Okay, so we can say that if we want to find out the direction of magnetic force, then we will put the direction of IL cross B. So current is in capital Y direction, so J cap, and B is X direction, so I cap. Now what is the answer of J cross I? Minus K cap. Okay, so on this AB wire, magnetic force will be in minus K cap, means negative Z axis direction. So on this AB, there will be magnetic force, it will be in this negative, means downward. Okay, F1 will be downward. We can also show it direction by cross because it is downward. Same as on CD. On CD, again suppose we want to find out the direction of magnetic force. Okay, then it is again IL cross B. Here, see, current is in negative Y axis direction. So minus J cross I, it will be K cap. So force, magnetic force on this CD wire will be in upward Z direction, so it will be upward like this. It will be F2. Here the magnitude of F1 and F2 will be same. Okay, because current I is also same, length L is same, that is B. Okay, but direction is opposite. Okay, here I am also writing the magnitude, that is the IBB, and here also magnitude IBB. This is for direction. This is also for a direction. Okay, now see figure carefully. On this AD wire, magnetic force is 0. BC wire, again magnetic force is 0. On AB wire, magnetic force is inward. On this CD wire, magnetic force is outward. So we can say that on this rectangular loop, there are two forces acting, F1 and F2. Both are same in magnitude, but both are opposite. One is downward, another is upward. Okay, so net magnetic force will be 0. Okay, net magnetic force on loop will be 0. But here, there is some perpendicular distance. There is some perpendicular distance between these force F1 and F2. Okay, and that will bring the torque in the picture, in this theory. So we can say that now, F1 and F2 are same in magnitude, but opposite in direction. Okay, so total net force will be 0, but F1 and F2 are not in same line of action. Okay, their line of action is not same. So torque will be generated. So net torque will not 0. Now we want to find out the torque. Here torque is R cross F. Now see this figure. In this figure we can say that actually we can simplify this figure like this. This is only one cross section of this rectangular loop. One force will be upward, that is the F2. One force is downward, that is F1. And this distance is actually A. Now you can find out the torque. Torque is force into distance. Okay, so we can say that टॉर्क इज इक्वल्स टू डिस्टेंस इज ए एंड फोर्स इज आई बी बी एंड साइन थीटा, हियर थीटा इज 90 डिग्री, सो थीटा इज 90 डिग्री, एफ एंड ए थीटा इज 90 डिग्री. ओके, सो वी कैन से दैट टाव इज इक्वल्स टू आई ए बी बी. सो टाव इज इक्वल्स, नाउ दिस ए बी, what is the here area of the rectangular cross section? See, we want to find out area, then A into B, A into B. So we can say that area A is equals to A into B. So torque tau is equals to IAB. Okay. So this is the formula of torque acting on rectangular loop. Formula of torque acting on rectangular loop. Okay, which is placed in uniform magnetic field. Now we will see universal formula. How universal? Suppose this rectangular is not placed in the plane of magnetic field. See here, this rectangular loop is placed in the plane of this magnetic field. Okay, like this we can say that suppose this is the rectangular loop. Okay, then it is placed like this and magnetic field is like this. But if loop is placed like this, then it is not in the plane of the magnetic field. So we have to consider also that case. So to consider that case, now I am giving you another figure that is like this. Okay, we are only draw the cross sectional figure that will be like this. Okay, suppose it is making angle theta with the plane of magnetic field. This is the plane of magnetic field. In this direction there will be magnetic field. Now in this direction there will be force F2, in this direction there will be force F1. Direction of force will be same. Okay, suppose this is center, then this distance will be a by 2 and this distance will be also a by 2 and total distance will be a. Okay, now this angle is theta. So again we want to find out the torque, that is the R cross F. Okay, now so we can say that torque tau is equals to R F sin theta, where theta is angle between force F and the distance R. Okay, the distance between the perpendicular, total distance between the F1 and F2. So torque tau is equals to, what is the R distance? That is the A. Again force I, F is I B B and sin theta. Okay, so torque tau is equals to I A B B sin theta. So torque tau is equals to I A B sin theta. Okay, so universally we can also say that torque tau is equals to I A cross B. Okay, we have terminated sin theta in accordance with this cross product. Okay, so we have placed the cross product instead of sin theta. So this is the universal formula of torque, whether it is placed, whether rectangular loop is placed in the plane of magnetic field or not. Okay, so actually you will remember this formula. Actually also you will not remember this formula. This is the formula for only one rectangular placed, one rectangular loop is placed. Now suppose n rectangular loops are placed, then what will be the total torque? That will be actually n I a cross b. Total torque will be n I a cross b. Okay, this is the formula for only one loop. This is the formula for n loop. So torque is equals to n I a cross b. Now in this chapter we will define this n I a or I a as magnetic moment. Okay, this is the new term, that is the magnetic moment. Remember in first chapter there was dipole moment. Okay, there was dipole moment, same as here there is magnetic moment. Magnetic moment is denoted by M. Magnetic moment is denoted by M, and the formula of M is I into A. okay, it is vector quantity and formula of m is I into a. If there are n loops, so formula of m is n I a. What will be the unit of magnetic moment? See, unit of magnetic moment is unit of current will be ampere, and unit of area will be meter square. So this is the unit. You can also define the find out the dimensional formula of magnetic moment. Now we will put magnetic moment m in this formula, so we will have final formula of torque. Okay, that is the torque tau is equals to, actually we have defined this n I a cross b, but we can say that n I a is equals to magnetic moment m. So torque tau is equals to m cross b or m b sin theta. Okay, now in which direction there will be m? In the direction of area. In the direction of area there will be magnetic moment. Okay, so this is the torque acting on rectangular loop. Now we will see various conditions of this rectangular loop in the magnetic field. Okay, first is stable condition. Actually, these are the equilibrium condition. You can also say stable equilibrium condition. When stable equilibrium condition will be there, when theta will be 0. See, when theta is equals to 0, then torque is equals to mb sin 0 is equals to 0. That means no torque will be act on loop, and loop will be at stationary or at rest. It will not rotate. Okay, loop will not rotate. When this is happening, when theta is 0, what is now theta? Theta is the angle between m and b. M is the direction of area. So it will be happen like this. See this is suppose loop is placed like this and magnetic field is like this. Now area of this loop is in this direction, perpendicular to the plane. So area is in this direction, magnetic field is also in this direction. So angle theta will be 0. So this is the stable condition of the rectangular loop. Okay, now second is unstable condition. This is the same as chapter number 1, dipole, torque on dipole. When theta is equals to 90 degree, then torque tau is equals to maximum, that is the mb sin 90, that is the mb. Now here loop will rotate, and loop will rotate in which direction? Loop will rotate so that it will be in again stable condition. Okay, so we can say that when loop is placed in magnetic field like this, it will rotate, until it is reaching in this stable condition. Okay, when you again place loop in this manner, then again loop will be in this stable condition. Okay, because here theta will be 0. So this is the torque acting on this rectangular loop in uniform magnetic field. Okay, so we have studied the formula of torque, that is the NIAB or NIA cross B, but we have taken the NIA is equals to magnetic moment, that is M. Okay, its unit is ampere meter square. You can also find the dimensional formula of it. So finally the formula of torque will be tau is equals to m cross b is equals to mb sin theta. We have also discovered the two conditions of this rectangular loop, that is the stable condition and unstable condition. Where rectangular loop will be in stable condition when theta is 0. So when we can say that loop is placed perpendicular to the magnetic field, because when loop will be placed perpendicular to magnetic field, then area of loop will be in the direction of magnetic field, so it will not rotate. And unstable condition means theta is equals to 90 degree or 270, you can say anything. So when theta is equals to 90 degree, then loop will rotate, and it is the unstable condition. Okay, thank you.